Thoughts, what's going through your mind right now?
There's been a lot that's gone really the last 48 hours for me, so a lot of different emotions. You know, I just appreciate the fact that I had six amazing years with this organization. The friends that I made on this team will be friends forever, guys that I'll talk to forever. The fan base was, I just, everything about my experience here was more than I ever could imagine. So it's definitely a lot of different emotions going on right now.
Do you have a contract offer imminent with an NFL club?
That's really why we're here today, is allow me to explore that and be able to make a decision quickly, rather than having to wait till the end of the free agency deadline. So there's a good opportunity for me out there, and I want to make the most of it and showcase my talents for them.
Are you allowed to tell us with who?
I am not. Until there's a contract officially signed and all of that stuff taken care of, I've been instructed that I can't say who the team is.
Is it just one team, or do you have a couple of options?
There were some different interests out there throughout this offseason, but I've got a decision made, and it's kind of just come down to the point where we just need to cross the T's and dot the I's.
How exciting is that for you to finally have this opportunity? I know it's one you've wanted for quite some time.
Ever since first time I touched a football, that's something I dreamed about, is having an opportunity to play in the NFL, on the game's biggest stage. To kind of get to that point now, it's pretty surreal. It's exciting for me. I'm looking forward to the situation that I'm in right now, and the potential for me to earn myself a spot on a team is there.
If it works out for you, was this the perfect way for you to leave Rider Nation with a Grey Cup?
Absolutely. I wouldn't have it any other way. A chance to play in a Grey Cup and win a Grey Cup in front of our fans, there's no better way to go out than that.
Have you talked to Darian yet?
I haven't, not yet. Like I said, a lot has happened very quickly, really, in the last 24, 48 hours for all this to happen, and I haven't really had a moment to relax here for a bit.
When we talked to you early on, you said, it would have to be a right fit for you, and it's not just going down there just to kind of dip your toe in the water. You're going down there to play. Is this offer that you have to make a decision on, basically, would it be sizable? And what I mean by that is maybe upfront guaranteed money that would have you believe that this is something real, more than just kind of training camp stuff.
For me, from the start of this, before any money contract was ever mentioned, my first instinct was to find a place that wanted me there and that had a need for a player like me, so I was in a good position to go into a training camp and battle for a spot on the roster. Money wasn't a factor for me in this decision. It's a decision based on an opportunity, a situation that I feel like I have a very good chance to make a football team.
You touched on the emotion that you feel. How difficult is it to leave this fan base, knowing that you're one of the more popular players here and you've kind of been adopted by this?
It's been very difficult. It's 6 years here playing in front of these fans is a very special experience, something I'll always remember. Being able to interact with the fans and the community as much as I have, as much as we as players are able to do that, is pretty special. I thank all the fans for the support that I've been given throughout the last couple months since the end of the season. The support has been there for the most part, but I know that this fan base cares about the players that are here, and I would like to say that the team that I'm talking with, I've made a request for a certain jersey number, and I requested jersey number 13 because I wanted to show my respect to the 13th man of Rider Nation, and if everything works out the way that I'm hoping, I'll be able to wear 13 on Sundays, and Rider Nation will be out on the field with me in that aspect.
When you came here 6 years ago, you said you never expected anything like this. What did you expect?
To be honest, I didn't know what I was getting myself into at all. You know, coming into the CFL, it's a league that really didn't know really anything about. I knew that receivers got motion. That was pretty much it. The field is bigger. But just to learn about this organization and what it means to this province and the fans around Saskatchewan is, it was a great learning experience for me and something very special to be a part of.
How's your hometown feeling today?
It's pretty good. I guess the few people that I've had a chance to talk to haven't had much time for that, trying to figure everything out. So, you know, just a chance to talk to mostly family at home. And it's been an exciting time for us. And, you know, I just look forward to the opportunity in front of me.
Do you know when you'll be able to announce which team it is?
No, not for sure yet. As far as I know, basically I have to get in and be able to do the physical and pass that. And once that's cleared, we're able to sign the contract. So hopefully not too long from now.
What about the idea of coming back if things don't work out? Is Saskatchewan your number one destination that way, or would you?
Haven't thought about it. I'm 100% focused and committed on making this opportunity work for me. And I'm not thinking about what could happen 6, 7, 8, 9 months from now, whatever it is, because that situation is going to be different than it is now. So there's no sense in, for me, wasting time on thinking about what's impossible to predict.
What was that whole process for you like, just auditioning for that game, just your first taste of the NFL?
It was pretty laid back, actually. I just went in and basically I got to run around, catch some balls for them, and do what you do every day as a receiver, catching passes, running routes. Felt like just a quick little workout that I would do on my own with a quarterback, you know, out on the field at any point in time. So, you know, to go through all that, they were very helpful at getting me down there and all that stuff. And there's a... I don't know, it was just a good experience to do that and get a chance to know some of the guys.
Do you think the way the NFL has changed the last few years really helped your chances to get this chance?
I think so. I think the fact that the NFL has become a little bit more of a passing league than maybe a few years ago when I was coming out of college might have created more spots that I could compete for.
Will punt returning be in your repertoire down there?
Yes.
Is that going to be primary, or are you going to be primary
receiver? They're bringing me in as a punt returner and as a slot receiver.
Has this had a chance to sink in with you? After the Grey Cup, we talked about the possibility of you signing down there. Now it's becoming more of a reality. Has it sunk in yet?
Not yet. I think once we get the full contract finalized, obviously there's still a few things that need to be done before anything can happen. So. I think once you get over that hurdle, then you can start thinking about football and what you need to do at that point to make the team.
Is the punt return thing, is that going to be different for you? Have you thought about, you know, fair catch as opposed to the no-yard situation? Is that anything different?
Yeah, it's a different style of return game, obviously. You know, I did all the punt return in my 4 years in college that I was there, so I'm used to that style, and I've been doing punt returns sparingly up here the last 6 years, so it's definitely a different style of return game, and I'll have to you know, do my homework and practice up to be able to get more and more comfortable with that, you know, as I get down there.